You use applications like Instagram, Facebook, Netflix. You even know that these companies collect your data. Everyone knows about it, everyone talks about it. These companies collect the data because they want to make better decisions, understand their customers, and improve the overall business process. But do you know how all of these things happen from the technological standpoint view? In this video, I will give you the complete understanding of it. The growth of data is massive and exponential. As per the recent report, 90% of the world's data was generated in just last 2 years. And this report is just 2 years old. If you look at the bigger picture, you use your phones and computer on daily basis. The amount of data that is getting generated and processed on daily basis is massive. Now, these data generally get stored on some relational databases like PostgreSQL or as a text file on some file-based storage system. But at the end, all of these data get stored at one place. It is something called as data warehouse. Data warehouses are the system especially built for analytical workloads. So when you want to store the huge volume of data and read them in bulk, you can easily do that using data warehouse. You can also find the answers to these questions such as, how much time did this user spend on this page today compared to yesterday? How did we do this on this particular product sale this year compared to last year's? All of these questions can be easily answered within seconds using data warehouse. So when companies like Google, Facebook started growing, they started collecting massive volume of data and they wanted to process this data and find the valuable insights from it. Those were the days when very few people had the access to the internet and all of these websites. So the amount of data that used to get generated was very less and it was very easy to process them using the traditional technologies. But as more and more people started getting access to the internet, the data started growing at the exponential rate. At this time, the traditional data warehouse technologies were not capable enough to handle the huge volume and the speed at which the data was getting generated. They had the architecture like this. This is the shared disk architecture where you have one disk and multiple users trying to connect via some network. Or the other architecture was like this, where you have the shared databases, but to run the query, you have to use the distributed query across different nodes. In a nutshell, all of these technologies were not able to handle the speed and the size of the data that was getting generated at that time. Traditional data warehouse systems started to struggle. They also required the significant time and resources to scale your databases. Performance was the big issue. If you want to process the huge volume of data, it might take days or even weeks. And more than that, the cost of managing all of these things were very expensive. Businesses were losing on the valuable insights because they couldn't process data on time or in efficient manner. And the last thing is that all of these data warehouse technologies only supported the limited data types. So if you want to store the data, you have to make your data into the structured format. So we have something called the ETL, extract, transform, load, where you extract data from multiple places, do some transformation, and then you load the structured data onto the data warehouse. So you have to do this entire processing before you even load your data onto the data warehouse. So all of these technologies couldn't handle the new age of data and we needed something modern. And this is where the Snowflake database comes into the picture. Now, before we go forward, I just want to say that I'm not sponsored by Snowflake at all. This is the modern database that is gaining the popularity and you will understand why as we go forward in this video. So Snowflake is a new type of data warehouse available in the market that is entirely on the cloud. The cloud means you are using someone else's computer. So in the traditional data warehouses, you had to buy your own hardware, make sure everything scales properly, update the software. Even if you rent the server from someone else, you had to manage most of the things by yourself. But the concept of data cloud changed the entire game. Now you don't have to worry about all of these things. You just need to focus on your business side and make sure how you process your data. What's cool about Snowflake is that how it processes and stores your data. It keeps your data storage and your compute layer separate so that businesses can store more and more data and also process this data in an efficient manner. So this is the architecture of the Snowflake to understand it better. At the bottom, we have the data storage layer where all the data really gets stored. Then we have the compute layer where we can allocate resources to process our data and run query. And we have the cloud service layer where you can access different features like authentication, security, and manage the overall infrastructure. So for example, if you have multiple teams working within the organizations, you can create something called as the virtual warehouses where you can allocate different sizes of CPUs and RAM for different teams. And based on their requirements, they will only use the allocated resources. This way you will not face the performance challenges. And even if you need more resources, database, it will scale all of these systems. This makes Snowflake one of the most powerful database technology available in the market. That is not it. Snowflake is adapting to support the next wave of enterprise workload. There are so many new things that Snowflake has added based on the problem they see in the market. For example, if you want to store the structured, unstructured data, you can easily do that. If you want to query data that is stored at some different location, you can also create tables on top of it and start querying it. You don't have to move your data from that location to your location. Also, you don't really require the ETL part. You can directly load your data onto Snowflake and then do the transformation using Python code, SQL code, or even Spark code. One of my favorite features on Snowflake is something called as a Snowpipe. So if you want to create the data pipeline based on some event, so let's say your data is coming onto the Amazon S3. So whenever any new file gets uploaded, the Snowpipe will get triggered and it will directly store your data onto the Snowflake table. So this is one of the most powerful features I have seen. What Snowflake does is that they work with the large enterprises and tries to understand what the real problem is. And based on that, they try to solve these problems by building the right feature. And they have like hundreds of features that you can explore. So let's look at the end-to-end example to understand the Snowflake in action and see what you can do with it. Now, before we move forward, I just want to plug my course here is that if you want to learn the data warehouse technology, that is one of the most important skills you need to know as a data engineer. I have created the in-depth course where you will learn everything about the data warehouse fundamentals. You will do multiple projects and you will understand the Snowflake database in depth. It took me 3 to 4 months to build this entire course. So I will highly recommend you to at least check it out. You will find the link in the description. Let's continue with our example. Whenever you want to learn anything, the first step is not to find courses, resources, books. The first step is to go to the website and create your account. Okay, just get started. All you have to do is just write Snowflake on your browser and you will be redirected to the Snowflake page. Here you will understand what Snowflake is and everything about it. The first step we want to do here is that create your account for free. They provide 3 trials for 30 days and you also get $400 worth of credit. So all you have to do is just fill your information over here. So I'll do that. Once you fill your basic information, then they will ask you to choose the Snowflake edition. You have 3 options, standard, enterprise, and business critical. So we will go with the business critical version because that provides most of the features that we want. After that, you can choose your cloud provider. So if you're working in a company and they have their existing infrastructure on particular cloud, you can choose one. Over here, I'll just go with the AWS and region. You can select the nearest region as per your location. So for me, the nearest region is the Singapore. Click over here, get started. You can fill all of these basic information or you can just skip this. Once you do that, you will get the activation mail on your email. So you can go to your register email and here you will find all of the information. Just click on to the click activate. Once you do that, you just have to fill your username. Then you will be redirected to the Snowflake UI. So this is the basic tutorial. So the important thing over is that you bookmark your URL. Then you can also follow the basic tutorial. But for now, I'll just skip this. So this is the UI of Snowflake. As you can see, you will get the worksheet. Worksheet is basically where you write all of your SQL queries. Then you have the dashboard. So whatever the dashboard that you create will be displayed here. We also have the Streamlit if you want to create the interactive visualizations. Applications, so they also provide a third-party application that you want to integrate. Then here you will find all of this information about your data. So all of the databases that you have, whatever the sharing of the data that you do. So overall management of the data can be done over here. They also have the marketplace. So if you want to get some data for the trial purposes, so if you want to practice the SQL on real world data set, then you can find all of this data set already available for free. So you can play with the Snowflake UI and get more understanding about it. So if you just play with that, you will get used to this UI. So you will get more comfortable learning Snowflake. So here, all you have to do is just click on this plus icon and click onto this SQL worksheet. Then you will see this is my Snowflake, so this is all of my data and this is the sample data that you can use to write the query. So this is pretty simple. First, you make sure that you have selected the warehouse on top of it. Then over here, you select your database. So just click onto the database that you want to use. You can also select the specific schema. So in this case, I will go with this particular schema that has the tables and data that we want to query. So the first query that you can write is something like this, which is a select query. So over here, the query I'm writing is a select star from this particular database. Then there is a schema name and there is a table name. So if I run this using this, you will see it will start running this particular query on this sample table and you will get the output. So this is scanning the entire table and giving you the final output. So as you can see, this is the table information. You can see it over here. Currently, it is only displaying the 10,000 rows, but this table has like millions of rows. So it has like 15 million rows available. You can also get more understanding about the query, that how much time it took. If you want to debug that, you can just click onto this query ID and you will get the information about each and everything that this query did in the backend. So it did the table scan and gave you the result. So you can also limit the result set just by putting the limit as 10. We can also run more queries. So let's say if you want to run something like this, where I'm just aggregating this entire quantity as a total quantity sold from this particular table. If I run this, we'll get the complete information about the total quantity sold. Now I can do more analytics on top of it. It is pretty simple. You just have to write the right query. If you have the basic SQL understanding, this might be pretty simple to understand. What I'm doing is that I'm just trying to query this particular table and joining this table based on the customer key that is available on both of these tables, the order table and the customer table, and then selecting these four columns. It will take like 30 to 40 seconds to run this query, and once you do that, you will get the final result set given to you. So if you want to understand about your compute warehouse resources, you can just go to the admin. You will find the warehouses over here. As you can see, we have the compute warehouses that is currently running. If you want to create your own warehouse, you can just click onto this plus, give the warehouse name as test. Over here, you have all of these options available. You can just click onto the create warehouse. You also have the advanced option. So if you want to auto resume it, auto suspend it after some minutes. Now Snowflake has a lot of different features, time travels, soap pipe, and all of these other things. I can't teach all of these in just overview videos. As I already told you, I have the detailed course on data warehouse for data engineers using Snowflake. So I highly recommend you to at least check it out. This was the complete overview about Snowflake. Again, the intention of this video was not to make you master of Snowflake, but give you the quick overview about this technology so that you get the confidence about learning this particular thing. This is pretty easy. All you have to do is just understand the UI and bits and pieces of it. Once you do that, you will get the confidence. Okay, so this was all from this video. I hope you gained the clarity. If you did, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you are new here. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.